Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Aditya 11TTT. Today here we are going to discuss about how to recover the dead IT IO if by mistake we write a wrong program. If we program a wrong BIOS to an IT chip, it will lead to a dead situation and it will not detect. So we will be discussing about it theoretically and practically. Now I'll tell you what all things you have to do. First, you have to connect the socket and connect the IT. Okay, this is the, you can see this is the socket. You have to put the IT IC inside it and connect to the programmer. Okay, after doing that, by mistake, suppose you have written a wrong program, okay, you will see that IT has gone to dead situation and it will say IT is busy and cannot be detected, or IT is not present. So what we'll do is we have to add a SPI blank ROM over here. You can see we have added a SPI blank ROM over here and we have made the connection over here. Okay, now what we have to do is we have to make a jumper. You can see the jumpers are being made over here. After doing that, we have to go to the interface of SVOD, select IT, and then select the IT128 zip. Okay, after that you have to press on read ID and leave it for 2-3 minutes. Till the time, all the data will be written from here to here and making it blank. Okay, after some time we have to remove this particular jumpers from here. Okay, after removing the jumper from here, we have to follow the same process. We have to select IT and then press on 128 zip over there and then press on the read ID. After removing jumper, you will find that IT is being detected. Now we will be moving to the practical part of this particular theory and see it, how it actually practically works, how the IC goes to dead situation and how can we revive it. We'll see further in this particular video. Okay, now here we will be programming an IT IO. Inside this we have an IT IO. I'll show you. You can see this is the IT IO. It is 8586 EIO. Okay, now in this particular video we will be talking about if by mistake you tend to write a wrong program on this particular IO, what will be happening to the IO, whether it will survive or it will die or what will happen. So what we are going to do is we are first going to check it on the program whether the ID is detecting or not. So first we are going to select on the IT over here, then we will be going to the setup, then we will be selecting over to your select motherboard, then ITE zip, we will be going directly and we will be pressing OK button and press on the read ID. You can see right now the ID is being detected, and if we try to read the data, you will find there is no data over here. It is all UU written, something like that. So what we are going to do is we are going to erase the file once, then read it again. Okay, after doing that you'll find all, it is all empty right now, there is no data at all. So what we are going to do is we are going to just open the file. Okay, and we are going to write a you can say this is a bias which is corrupted. This is a corrupted bias, okay? This is not a okay bias, and we are going to write it over here. Now let's do one thing, we write it. You can see the data is writing right now. The data is writing right now, you can see just it is writing, and it has verified. Okay, now what we'll do, we'll try to close the program. Okay, we'll try to read the first data is reading or not, I don't know. Okay, now you can see it says it has been written. Now we are going to close it, and we'll try to run the program again. As soon as we run the program, you'll find We'll first find the IT, select IT, then setup, then select motherboard, then type 128 IT, we'll select again and we'll press on OK button, and as soon as we press on read ID, you'll find IT is busy and IT is not detecting. Again you will find IT is busy, IT is not detecting. That means the that particular IC has been damaged due to wrong program. Okay. Now how we will rectify this using this socket is, first you have to place one simple bias over here. The bias size should be bigger than the IO size, okay, that is 128 KB, it should be bigger than that. Secondly, we will be using chip select CS MOSI MISO, that is SI serial input, SO is serial output, and CLK is clock, that is pin number 1, pin number 2, pin number 5, and pin number 6 of this particular BIOS. Okay, now we will be making jumper to this particular pins. Okay, I'll make jumper. So we have made the jumper. Okay, we have made the jumper on this pins, pin number 1, 2, 5, and 6 of the respective pin. Now after making the jumper, what we have to do is, I'll try to show you is this. Now what we have to do is, after making the jumper, it was not detecting. We have to just go and select the IT over here. After selecting IT, we have to go to setup. Again, select the motherboard, and we have to type 128 over here. And we have to select on the IT zip, okay? As soon as you press on the IT zip and press on the read ID, you will find an error, IT is busy. Still, you are finding this error. Now, what we have to do is, we have to wait for the IO to take the empty files from the BIOS and write it on its block to make it zero. Until and unless it becomes all zero, or you can say it all becomes like you have seen in the starting of the video, this IO won't be able to read. Okay, now it will take some like 5 to 6 minutes to do all the process, and after that we'll find that IO is able to detect or not. So right now it is reading or writing what is happening, it is all inside, okay. Now we are waiting. Now we will be removing this cables, okay, we have to remove two cables from here, we will be removing that. So we have removed the cable from here. Now we will follow the process again. IT first over here again. After selecting IT, we will go to select motherboard. After selecting motherboard, we will click on 128 IT over here and we will press OK. After that, we have to press on the read IT just. You can see the data again, it is detecting. Okay, we have written some data. We will try to read it and see whether it is available or not. You can see we read. Now we'll check it over here. You can see the data is not available, it's not the same data which we wrote, it's all UW something like that. So the data is totally gone. So what we are going to do is, we are going to erase it and then again read it again and see whether the data is now YY or not. You can see the data is completely blank now. So this is how you can repair your IT IO if it goes faulty on this particular board. This is the simplest way to repair your IT IO if you program a wrong EC BIOS into your IT, it will go to dead situation. Okay, so thanks for watching our channel Aditya 1120. Hope you like our channel, do hit the subscribe button, like, share and comment. Hope you learned today something, and if you want to purchase this particular program, you can just contact us. Thanks a lot.